The Florida Panthers got a big win prior to the holiday break, opened up their new practice facility in downtown Fort Lauderdale, and have representation at this year's World Junior Championships.
Your Locked On Panthers, your daily podcast on the Florida Panthers. Part of the Locked On Podcast Network, your team every day.
And welcome into this Tuesday, December 26th edition of the Locked On Florida Panthers podcast, part of the Locked On Podcast Network, where it's your team every day. Thank you for making the Locked On Florida Panthers podcast your first listen of the day. I'm Armando Velez from the Hockey News, and you can follow me on X at MondoMan12. Follow the show account on X and Instagram at LO_FLAPanthers. And shout out to the everydayers who come back here and get your daily Florida Panthers fix. And today's episode is brought to you by Game Time. Download the Game Time app, create an account, and use code LOCKEDONHL for $20 off your first purchase. And I want to say to all of you that I hope that you all had a Merry Christmas. If you do happen to celebrate, happy Boxing Day to everyone who celebrates as well. And I hope that everyone just has a safe holiday season. And I hope that you all have a sense of community as well during this time of year, because it is not an easy time of year for a lot of families as well, where whether you're working a whole bunch of hours and you're just trying to get a gift for, if you have a son who, if you're working 60 hours a week and you're trying to scratch and claw to get them a gift for them to feel happy this holiday season. So it can bring a lot of happiness and it could bring a lot of stress to a lot of people. And I hope that all of you out there, regardless of what you're going through, that you have that sense of community around you throughout this time of year. So wishing all of you that. But for the Florida Panthers, prior to the holiday break, got a big win on Saturday afternoon from Amerant Bank Arena. Prior to the holiday break, the Vegas Golden Knights were just coming off an East Coast trip towards the tail end of it, where without two of their goalies, Logan Thompson and Aiden Hill. And listen, we spoke about this even previewing this matchup, that around the goaltenders, that the Vegas Golden Knights protect them well. And they are no stranger to revolving doors around goaltenders throughout even in their inaugural season back in 2017-2018 as well. And the Panthers, I mean, really, when it came to this game, eliminating speed through the neutral zone to create rush chances. And Paul Maurice spoke about how on Thursday when they lost to St. Louis Blues about how they were trying to force feed their rushes and getting away from their game. Obviously, if you saw how the first 20 minutes went for the Florida Panthers, the Panthers were performing and playing what the game gave to them is what I'm trying to say as far as their rush chances. And I know they weren't converting multiple 3-on-2s and odd man rushes as well. So the Panthers, I mean, offensive zone time, 11 minutes to 4 after the first period, and you're thinking, man, these guys are just not converting. You were seeing maybe somewhat flashes of the game on Thursday night as well for the Panthers. I mean, but the top line for the Cats, Barkov, that line was incredible, creating their opportunities. Even the third line, Anton Lundell, his first game back in about a week as well. So those lines were getting it going as they were creating their chances, especially in the neutral zone early. And then I know that Vegas, they got 3 shots on goal through the first period and double and got that amount within the first 5 minutes, 13 in the second, and got down early. It's like, man, you're getting all these chances, and then the Vegas Golden Knights convert on really early on into the second period. But I mean, when it talks about the rush chances and scoring on them, only one of their four goals came on that. And it was the first one just 5 minutes after being down 1-0. Bennett gains the zone, stops on a dime, lets the screen develop so that Patera doesn't even see his shot through the screen. And then the other ones were cycled around for the Panthers as well. Well, not the Gus Forsling one. It was right off a faceoff off the boards, and then a slap shot gets through some traffic as well. But Panthers got two power play goals as well on the afternoon, cycling the puck around, allowing for bodies to get in front and to take away the eyes. And that was really what was key for the Panthers as well through that. And the score was tied 2-2 towards in the beginning of the third period and all. And I thought for the Panthers they for the most part, in my opinion, I think you really created more of that positive momentum for them, even though if you look at the final score, it doesn't really say how dominant the Panthers were. I thought the Vegas Golden Knights were a lot slower. They were on the tail end of a trip, wanting to go home. They have a Winter Classic to prepare for, by the way, as well, on January 1st against the Seattle Kraken. Not making any excuses and all, but you think about how the Panthers in that power play for the Vegas Golden Knights early on, that they were a minute and 30 seconds in their own zone without a clear. And still the Panthers were able to not allow the Vegas Golden Knights to score on that one. They go perfect 2-for-2 on the PK. Carver Hagee on the power play scored his 100th goal of his career, doing it in 235 games. The only one to do it faster is Pavel Bure in 138 games. And he did it on January 30th, 2001, against the Tampa Bay Lightning on a power play goal that cut the Lightning deficit to 3-2. But unfortunately, Tampa Bay ended up winning that one 4-3. And also, we got to talk about the fight at 11:55 of the first period between Ryan Lomberg and Keegan Kolesar, knocking him out in one punch as well. And Keegan Kolesar went to the locker room for a little bit. And we all know the history of Kolesar knocking out Matthew Tkachuk, breaking his sternum in game 3 of the Stanley Cup final, and just fighting through it in game 4 before he ultimately couldn't play in game 5 as well. I asked Ryan Lomberg after the game, asking him, have you ever heard of the manga / anime One Punch Man? And he answered saying, is that about me? And I thought it was a pretty funny quote as far as that from Ryan Lomberg. And Matthew Tkachuk spoke about it after the game, how Ryan Lomberg has a lifetime contract in his book because, you know, standing up for your friend, your teammate. And I'm not sure how to put this into words, but I'm not saying the Panthers' spirits were crushed, but when you knew that Matthew Tkachuk wasn't going to be playing in game 5 and then seeing how he fought through it in game 4, at the time, I'm just thinking, man, the writing's on the wall for this to end in 5. But you were hoping going into that the Panthers could put up a fight as well for that as well. Carter Verhaeghe did ask Carter Verhaeghe on what it meant for him to get goal number 100 as a Panther. That was actually his 109th of his career, 100 as a Panther, and just spoke about how he's thankful for the franchise believing in him as well when it comes to that. And he's a cap casualty. Remember when the Tampa Bay Lightning won the Stanley Cup the first time in the bubble and the Panthers pounced on it and now have a goal scorer that can get 40 goals in any given season at the rate that Carter Verhaeghe scores. And we're not even at the 41 game mark yet for the Florida Panthers. And he's just at continuing that rate to be in the high 30s, 40s for the Panthers as well. So, and he's under contract for another season after this. So very good bargain once again for Bill Zito as well. And also for the Panthers in this one, just incredible 5-on-5 play where over 35% of the Vegas Golden Knights shots were from even strength versus the power play as well. So that the Panthers were able to really eliminate the Vegas Golden Knights and what they do at 5-on-5, which that has been a continuing theme for the Panthers throughout this season as well. And just big performance as well for the Panthers as far as creating positive momentum going into the holiday break. But we're going to talk more about the Panthers' new and shiny practice facility in segment number two here. And we're going to, and I'm going to give my take as I got to see this incredible venue in person. We're going to talk about this and more here on the Locked On Florida Panthers podcast. Today's episode is brought to you by FanDuel Sportsbook. And right now, customers get $150 in bonus bets on any winning $5 money line bet. That's $150 if your team wins. And if you've been thinking about joining FanDuel, there's no better place to get in on the action. The app is super easy to use. There's a wide range of betting options, including spreads, player props, over-unders, and more. I know it's not going to be easy for Dolphins wide receiver Tyreek Hill to get to 2,000 yards. Still needs, has a long way to go in, and only with two games left, in order to get up to 2,000 receiving yards as well. And if you want to put a bet on if he gets up to 2,000 yards receiving, you can place that all on FanDuel as well. And even if you want to put place a bet on the odds of the Miami Dolphins also getting the number one seed, which they will have to win out for, you can do that all on FanDuel. So visit FanDuel.com/lockedon and place your bets as the NFL season comes winding down. FanDuel, official partner of the NFL. Locked On has launched the first ever national sports 24/7 streaming channel on YouTube. Locked On Sports Today is here for you 24/7, covering the top sports stories of the day with local experts of Locked On, plus our national shows covering every league. Go to Locked On Sports Today on YouTube and subscribe to the first ever national sports 24/7 streaming channel. So the Florida Panthers opened up their new practice facility in downtown Fort Lauderdale, and it was actually the day before the game against the Vegas Golden Knights. So was able to travel down on Friday morning and get right to the venue, and just picture, I'm going to try to paint the picture as best I can via words. So you're facing the logo that says War Memorial Auditorium. You're walking a little bit to that walkway on the right-hand side, and the doors open. The very first thing you see on your right-hand side is the pro shop. And then through some doors, through some glass doors, there is the rink. But to the right side of it is a personal bathroom, and then past that is the media room for the head coach, Paul Maurice. And all the seats in that media room are leather as well, so it's very comfortable that you can possibly go possibly fall asleep in. But as far as going through the glass doors as well after the pro shop into the rink, facing north south geographically as far as in Fort Lauderdale, but north south as far as the rink, the starters net for the Panthers is the first one you see. And if you look to your right, that's where they come out of the tunnel from the locker room as well. And the ice looks fresh. Obviously, it's their first time skating on it. Big scoreboard up front where it says Baptist Health Iceplex, Florida Panthers logo, Baptist Health logo, big scoreboard there. And then two screens in the middle and one on the side. If you're looking at center ice, near side corner on the left-hand side, that is where the Zamboni entrance is as well. 1,000 seats in there. And then the front ones are, the very, very front ones are leather with the Florida Panthers logo as well on it as well. They do have plugs at the top part of it, so easy for me to like write some stuff up as I was typing my story there too. So pretty cool as far as the top part. In the middle on the top is the restaurant that's still building, and then behind it is the second sheet of ice that they are building as well there. And then easy exit and entrance through the 1,000 seat venue, so that not everybody is going out in the same exit. So everyone's not going to be congested there when going inside the new practice facility. And Matthew Caldwell spoke about how this is something that was in the works for a few years. We knew about it even before, less than a year into Bill Zito becoming the GM of the Panthers. So big, huge work by Matthew Caldwell and Vinny Viola, especially with their military backgrounds as well. They wanted to honor veterans, and they wanted to be in a location where it's great for proximity of the players and a good amount of people who live in the downtown Fort Lauderdale area. There's tennis courts, pickleball as well, the beach nearby, which a lot of the players, they commuted to the venue via golf carts. Bill Zito spoke about how it's a great day to be a golf cart salesman as well. So definitely something that's going to be, some players might invest in as far as getting to work as well. Palmer spoke about how there's going to be some 24-hour access there. Chances are it's like an ID card. You wave it and then you the door opens. So you don't even need to have management there. And and for the players, it's not going to be exposed right in the middle of it. It's just their gym, their locker room, and cafeteria as well. So picture this when you go right into the locker room. You are entering there's two doors, one that leads to the lounge / kitchen and one that leads to the hallway to exit. We go through that. And then on the very top, you see a big Florida Panthers logo, huge. It's not on the ground anymore, where we have to worry about stepping on a logo as well. I know I went somewhat through that, not only covering the Panthers in the locker room, but even being an FIU alum, don't step on the logo until you graduate as well. So Barkov's stall is right in the middle. He gets to face the logo on top. If you're watching this on the YouTube, I'm trying to picture myself in Barkov's stall looking. Big logo in front, and then right in front of me is four TVs in the locker room as well. Barkov spoke about how he loves the TVs in the locker room. There's about ten others in the gym and one in the meal room as well. So everybody gets to hang out, watch different sports, whether it's hockey or football as well. I'm not saying it's a tight space, but everything with behind the sheet of ice, when you go into the locker room, everything is right next to each other. So you can't help but bump into your teammates as well. And that could be good for camaraderie reasons as well. So you're not necessarily saying that you're forced to talk to each other, but it's easier to communicate as well. And that could really help with the chemistry as well for this team too. And so that is great when it comes to that. As far as when it's going to be open to the public, Matthew Caldwell spoke about how it's going to be opening up in phases. The first phase was the players, and then there's going to be a ribbon cutting ceremony. But the pro shop's not even done yet. So that is another step as far as that is as well when it comes to that. I did ask Matthew Tkachuk on this feeling of being home, and Tkachuk told me how this was a sales pitch as far as signing a contract here before the trade actually happened, the sign-in trade, the first one in NHL history. And this is something that he's been looking forward to for ever since he got here in the summer of 2022. And this was, and you think about this region, Stanley Cup final, all-star game. Fort Lauderdale is being sold as the Panthers territory, literally, no pun intended. I mean, I haven't seen, because the New York Yankees left spring training in Fort Lauderdale in 1995, so I was two. But we've seen the region has seen the Yankees there, Baltimore Orioles spring training as well, Fort Lauderdale Strikers, rest in peace, and now Inter Miami. But the Florida Panthers, with their venue here, they're near the players, and also the time saved. They already geographically have one of the toughest travel schedules for road games. And this is going to make it easier for home games. You don't have to travel 30, 35 minutes to Coral Springs anymore in traffic on 595 or 95 and Sawgrass. If you choose to do that route, there's multiple ways to get there, but you don't have to worry about that. And think about it. And if you follow the trends of practices as well, they only went to the ice den if they didn't have availability at the arena. So instead of always going to the arena, this is also beneficial for Amerant Bank Arena themselves to book more events there too, so that the Panthers can solely focus on practicing nearby, walking as well. So the mental side of things as far as commute time and energy put into travel, it's more at ease for this team and for the players involved and for the coaching staff. Paul Maurice walked 2 minutes and made his cup of coffee at the venue. And he says the cup of coffee at the venue is better. So, if the management is listening, I'd like to try that cup of coffee too. I mean, you know, I just saying as far as that. And once again, Bill Zito spoke constantly, and this was a question asked by Alex Baumgartner about them being Fort Lauderdale's and Broward County's team. He emphasized that more later on as the press conference went on too. So, and proximity is everything as well when it comes to that. So really looking forward to when you guys listen, the listeners, you guys get to experience this. If you guys get to an opportunity to drive by Holiday Park, there's going to be a ribbon cutting ceremony as well. Don't know an exact date. Matthew Caldwell said late February, maybe early March as far as that, but no exact date yet as far as that. So we will update you guys as it goes on, when we will see a ribbon cutting ceremony as well in downtown Fort Lauderdale at Holiday Park. But we're going to transition over to segment number three, where the Florida Panthers will have some representation at the 2024 World Junior Championships. We're going to talk about this and more here on the Locked On Florida Panthers podcast. Today's episode is brought to you by Game Time. And you shouldn't have to worry when you're buying tickets to your next big event. Game Time is the fast and easiest way to buy tickets to all sports, music, comedy, theater events near you. With killer last-minute deals, all-in prices, view from your seats, and their best price guarantee, Game Time takes the guesswork out of buying tickets. See the view from your seat before you buy so you know exactly what to expect when you arrive. All-in prices show up your total upfront so you know you're getting a great deal without hidden fees. Buy tickets in seconds with just two taps. Game Time has deals on tickets right up to the start of the event, and even an hour after it starts is the best place to find last-minute tickets. Find exclusive flash deals and sponsored deals on tickets for football, basketball, hockey, concerts, comedy, theater, and more. And with War Memorial Auditorium, the auditorium part opening up very soon, maybe you could use Game Time to get to for your concert-related things as well at War Memorial from Game Time. You could use that as well. With zone deals, you pick up to the section and Game Time picks the seats for an average of 18% savings. And the Game Time guarantee means you'll always get the best price if you find tickets in the same section and rows for less. Game Time will credit you 110% of the difference. Download the Game Time app, create an account, and use code LOCKEDONHL for $20 off your first purchase. Terms apply. Again, create an account and redeem code LOCKEDONHL for $20 off. Download Game Time today. Last minute tickets? Lowest price, guaranteed. Segment number three here on this Tuesday, December 26th edition of the Locked On Florida Panthers podcast. Thank you once again for making the Locked On Florida Panthers podcast your first listen of the day. So the Florida Panthers will be having some representation at the IIHF World Junior Championship at in Gothenburg, Sweden. This will be the seventh time that Sweden has hosted the event in its almost 50-year history of the World Junior Championships, this current edition of it. And want to give a plug to my friend Alex Baumgartner of Five Reasons Sports Network to go check out his article on his one-on-one interview with Panthers defenseman Merrick Alscher, third-round pick from the 2022 NHL entry draft to the Merrick Alscher and Czechia did unfortunately lose 6-2 this morning against Slovakia. That game started at 6 a.m. In Eastern Standard Time. But Merrick Alscher, third round pick for the Panthers. He was the first of the pick that the Panthers had back in 2022. You think about the Sam Reinhart trade to with Buffalo and the Sam Bennett trade to Calgary. So that meant that the first pick for the Panthers in the 2022 draft was Merrick Alscher. So as far as what he's doing this year with the Portland Winterhawks, as far as that is for and his career, excuse me, of 49 points in 147 games, but a plus minus, his plus minus is plus 28. So defensively, I know plus minus is not the be all end all, but when you think about when it comes to his lack of points, but you're seeing a plus of 28, you see that he's doing it on the defensive side as well. And then big body, 6'3", uses his big body to kill penalties and close gaps to force guys to the perimeter. And he is playing a big role already in game one of the World Junior Championships, where he is on the first pair as well, logged over 20 minutes in game one of their matchup against Slovakia, even in the loss. He did have a -3 today. So, but still, he's still going to be playing a big role for Czechia in their World Junior Championship as well. The second one for the Florida Panthers is Sandis Vilmanis, 2022 fifth round pick, 157th overall, 6'1", 192-pound forward, 73 points in 92 games career for the Sarnia Sting, but he's almost at a point per game this year. And third World Junior Championship as well for Sandis Vilmanis. Not a lot of production in his first 11 games. 3 points as well, but after how he's performed in Sarnia and getting more opportunities to get more shifts, more minutes, and all, I'm expecting the Sandis Vilmanis to get an increased role for Latvia when they do take the ice. Their first game today will be against Sweden at 1:30 Eastern Standard Time. All games will be streamed on, and you can view them on NHL Network in the United States. So Sandis Vilmanis will take the ice at 1:30 p.m. on NHL Network. So, well, like we said, third time through the World Junior, but also we've seen Vilmanis and Marek Alscher in not one but two Panthers D camps and rookie showcases as well for the Panthers. So very excited to see where their growth stands as well. And with Vilmanis, a very patient shot as well, especially when he gets guys out in front as far as shooting through screens as well. So, and Sandis Vilmanis did have a hat trick in a pre-tournament tune-up game against Norway. So there's a lot of confidence from Sandis going into this World Junior Championship. So look for number 22 on Latvia for Sandis Vilmanis, and number 27 on Team Czechia for Marek Alscher as well. Not only did Czechia already play, mentioned that earlier, but they will be playing tomorrow against Norway at 11 a.m. And after Sweden's after Vilmanis' game today against Sweden at 1:30, Vilmanis and Latvia will be playing Canada tomorrow, same time, 1:30 p.m. As well. And we will give you World Junior updates as we go. So that those are the first two games for the two Panthers representatives at the 2024 World Junior Championship. And I'll also a shameless plug, go check out my article at the Hockey News where I discuss more in depth about both Sandis Vilmanis and Marek Alscher as they are hoping to each break Canada's streak of World Junior Championships as they come into this tournament, winning the last two consecutive tournaments. So on tomorrow's edition of the Locked On Florida Panthers podcast, it's going to be a Winans Wednesday edition of the show. We are going to discuss more about the Panthers in this break, how beneficial it can be for them, and we are going to preview Wednesday night's game between the Florida Panthers and the Tampa Bay Lightning. But in the meantime, if you like what you're hearing, please subscribe to the podcast to be notified every single time the Locked On Florida Panthers podcast jumps into your podcast feed. Don't forget to also subscribe to the other shows on the Locked On NHL Network, including Locked On NHL, Locked On Fantasy Hockey, Flip Livingstone, and Stuart Roden, and Locked On NHL Prospects. Thank you for making the Locked On Florida Panthers podcast your first listen of the day. So I'm Armando Velez, signing off. And you've been listening to Locked On Florida Panthers podcast, part of the Locked On Podcast Network, where it's your team every day.